You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
Hi, we're Brett and Hinata, and these are our two dogos. Originally, this breed was it was the fighting dog of Cordoba, used mostly for fighting, and it wasn't good for pack hunting because it was too aggressive with the other dogs. So they banned the dog eventually because it was a very vicious dog that would a lot of times kill the female after breeding it. It was that bad of a dog, and so this Dr. Antonio Martínez took the dog and bred 9 other dogs into it through his lifetime to create the Dogo Argentino, which ultimately is a super dog that was loving, loyal, family dog, protection, and they could also go out there and kill wild boar and pumas. That was their function. That was what was needed in Argentina at the time.
The fighting dog of Cordoba was mixed with 9 other breeds. And there was the boxer and the pointer, the bulldog, the bull terrier, the Great Dane, the Great Pyrenees, the Irish wolfhound, the mastiff, and the dog de Bordeaux.
So in breeding these dogs, they have a switch personality. They can be extremely loving and protective of a house, but given a situation, they have a vicious side of them that is, it's appropriately used in hunting. They're not very much a dog you have to worry about with humans unless you're an intruder and you're trying to hurt the family. Originally, I was introduced to these dogs back in the 90s when nobody really heard of Dogos in the United States. They were around, but it was very rare. There was no internet, so you'd have to go to the library or read it in some obscure dog magazine. I was breeding Rottweilers at the time, which was doing great as a breeding business, and great dogs from Germany were making them a little bit bigger. That's what Americans wanted. And I was offered a trade for a Dogo back in the 90s, and I could not. It was a beautiful dog. I wanted the dog. I couldn't figure out how to use it. Where am I going to get a stud? It wasn't really a functional concept at the time. So ever since then, I've had these Dogos on my mind as an alternative dog in the future. So once my oldest Rottweiler got to be about 13, I thought it was a good time to switch over. Everything that I've read about them has been true. They're very, a Dogo is very much a Dogo, bred normally, nothing exceptional. Dogos are Dogos. They're going to protect you. They're going to be loving to your children. They're going to be an excellent family dog. And they're going to take down an intruder if there is one. But it doesn't happen so quickly. They're very reserved. That's why they don't jump to too many situations of fighting necessarily unless it's unless it comes to them and they're there to protect. This is Mambo. He just turned 2 not too long ago. He's probably got about another, I would say, 4 to 5 pounds to put on in his life. Mostly it'll be muscle. He'll probably peak out at around 4 or 5 years old. Ava, she's a little past 2. She's a 2.5.
2 years and 3 months.
2 years and 3 months. Her highest weight would be probably about 90, 95. We have another one at home also about 95. He comes from the De La Cocha bloodline, which is one of the dominant, in my opinion, because when I went to buy my breeding stock, I read all about it as much as you could, and I found out that the De La Cocha, their dogs, in my opinion, based on what all the information I've read, they are sticking with the standard of the dog. They're hunters. They're great with the family. They look amazing. They're beautiful specimens. So I got him as my stud. His mom is from originally from the La Cocha Ranch. She's from Argentina. There's a famous dog, Maracho. He's on National Geographic show. That's his uncle. So there's a lot of, and he has that La Cocha on both sides of his bloodline. So he's very strong. So a lot of his puppies and his dad and everybody, they all look a lot like him because the gene is very strong. Ava has, she's got Lococha in her too. She has, she was bred by a Del Rio. Amazing ability, agility, obedience. They did a lot of urban things with their dogs, unlike that you would have in Argentina hunting down boar. Texas has a lot of working dogs that hunt boar. There's a vast amount of Dogos in Texas that are just all nothing but working dogs. We bought our dogs to breed. We breed them. We're not into anything except making exceptional puppies that you can do whatever you want with them. It's just like, I use the metaphor like a Ferrari. You can buy it to race. You can buy it to as like a show dog to keep in your garage. Or you can take it out and street race it. Like, you can do whatever you want. We just want to make sure that the puppies we produce are Dogos and act like Dogos and do whatever you need to do with them. They're great at so many things.
Ava's father is a four-time UKC champion. So a great, great looking dog.
And this is what a feminine female looks like. The Dogos have mass. I have another one at home that's more of a masculine female. She's a classic female. Her males look a lot like Mambo and her father. That's kind of how you judge where a male puppy is going to fall into the deal. Females, his bloodline seems to be a little on the big bone, a little thicker. Most of the puppies that come out of her are probably going to be a little bigger than her, stocky wise, which isn't going to hurt the situation at all. That's desirable. And a Dogo ultimately is supposed to be the perfect athlete. They're not supposed to be overweight. They're supposed to be extremely physical. I know that when he sees anything wild, rabbits, anything like that, his power surge just comes on. He becomes this powerful dog that you totally understand how he could take down a wild boar at that moment. When he's just sitting here resting with the family, you don't see that. You rarely see that side of them. It only comes out when there's a real situation. And when you have an urban Dogo, is what these guys are, who've never seen a pig before, they calm down. There's no outlet for them. So it's more of playing rough, things like that. They're prey animals, but they prey on pigs and pumas. So cats generally will have a hard time with a Dogo, especially if it runs from a Dogo. It's like the closest thing they can get to a puma, and they'll jump on that opportunity. But that's an urban one. Now the ones that are used for hunting, they have a natural tendency, just like these guys, to hunt down a wild boar. They can go for miles and miles at a fast pace, hunting down and smelling this wild boar, and then right when they find it, they have a whole nother level of energy, adrenaline surge, that allows them to do the attack and take down the catch dog, to take down the pig, which is all that has been bred into them. It's a very specific dog. We've had no problem introducing them into this urban life that we have with our kids and babies and families. They work perfect. That's one of the parts of these dogs. As far as the physical attributes, they're extremely strong. Both females and males.
No smell.
They have good points. They have no smell, which was bred into them so that the pigs wouldn't pick up their scent. They shed, I would say, on average, on the less side. Not a big problem, but like a dog. What else can you say about them?
Yeah, they don't drool much.
Not big droolers. All our dogs live inside the house, and. For people that own Dogos and want them to be very normal with people, it's a really good idea to have that dog indoors. You keep Dogos outside as a living place, they're gonna start, they're very extremely smart. So what's gonna happen is they're gonna come up with ways and things to do for themselves that you're not maybe gonna like destroy your lawn furniture, hop the fence and go visit some other dogs. And the Dogo, as long as you keep them as a part of the family indoors, they will act like part of the family. They figure out who you are, who the family is, how to respond to everything, and then they become perfect house guests or house family. And most Dogo owners will tell you that the dog has figured out how to get on the couch, and how to get on your bed with your approval.
He loves my pillows.
Yeah, you could be against the whole thing in the beginning, but the dogs, they kind of, the way they pull you in with their love and their affection, you almost want to take care of them because they're not just some dog type. A lot of dogs are just dogs. They are what they are. These guys really try to get into your head with a relationship, and it's hard to really turn them down because they only mean good. We've had them, one of them sleeps with each of our daughters. We go places, I don't think twice about the protection that I've left them with at home. They could do a much better job than I could at protecting my house. I had a quick one, a story. I had my one female, 7 months old. I ran into an old boss manager that I didn't like, and he didn't like me. And he saw me on the street, and we were talking, and she started snarling at him at 7 months old. And I was like, wow, I didn't stop her, because I was like, yeah, I get that. You know, I don't like this guy either. And ultimately, he came a little closer and was asking about her, and she showed all of her teeth, like, you just better not even try to get close. And the concept of that, I figured out later, was they don't understand words. They just know emotions, and clearly the guy didn't like me. And she got that. Clearly, I didn't like him, and she picked up on that real quick. And she saw a bad situation that she needed to keep that guy away. And that's a dogo. They jump to the chance to protect you, and they're not crazy about it. I mean, she could have went off on him, but she growled and did everything she could just to keep the guy away at the moment. That was the first line of defense. So there, as far as protection and having a crazy wild dog on your hands, I don't think that's the dogo. Just like any dog not trained properly or allowed to be wild, they'll be wild. But the pure nature of a dogo is very respectful towards people in general. They second guess any kind of a human confrontation. But if it's real, it's real. And then you got something on your hands to protect you with. If you're considering getting a dogo, the best thing you can do is do a lot of research. There's a lot of information that I've read out there that I laugh at. It's not even, typically they're written by people who don't own dogos. You really want to go to people who actually own dogos. You know, Facebook, places like that, you can actually, real people, and you'll find them talking about how affectionate and loving they are. And then you'll see them on a hunt full of blood, which is, that's the dogo if you use it for hunting. The people that should not own dogos, I would say, are elderly people who can't control a dog of this size. That just is common sense. People who aren't home very often and they think they want to keep their dog in the backyard, they're not a good fit for a dogo. A dogo needs interaction. It needs a family situation, just like a kid. You can't just leave a kid home all the time and expect him to come out good. You know, you have to interact. There's got to be some things. So if somebody just wants a macho dog in the backyard, that's probably all they're going to get out of a dogo, and it's not going to be a good fix for the dogo or you. He's going to cause you collateral problems.
Yeah, they love their families, and they need to be around their family. That's what's the best.
And I have seen dogos live with cats. They live with other dogs. They do that whole thing. The problem that may come up that we had with a cat was Mambo finally, he chased a cat once up a tree, and he got the idea that cats are for chasing. That's when the whole thing kicked in. So then he came back and looked at our cat as the next meal. So that cat took off. It understood what was happening. We had to take the cat out of his mouth. He wasn't there to kill it. A lot of times dogos, their whole purpose isn't to kill the prey. As they do with the wild boar, they pin the wild boar down. Usually it's the alpha hunter who comes along and finishes the job with a knife. So they do leave some discretion to the owner. I have seen that with other dogs, even with dogs that come up against a dogo in a park or something. A lot of times it just ends in them being pinned down. It's a submission move. They're not bloody hungry. That's not what it's all about with them. It's about the control and with you. All right, thanks for listening. I'm Brett, and this is Hinata, and these are our two dogs, Mambo, Ava, and we have another one home, Sparta. We have a website, puredogo.com. If you have any questions, about Dogos, if they're a fit for you, feel free to get us through our website and we'll answer any questions you may have.